Welcome back to another episode of Super Tech Saturday. I don't actually know if that's the name of this, but every Saturday I hope to come to you with some new, like, tech video. And today, I want to do the ultimate comparison between what I think are kind of competitors. The AirPods Max, the Bose 700s, and the Sony WH-1000XM4. I don't know why they have to have such crazy names. $550, $350, and currently on sale for $275, but normally about $350. Which headphones are the best, and which ones do I recommend? I'm gonna give you my thoughts on sound quality, noise cancellation, portability, price, the best bang for the buck, the best overall headphone for all day comfort, connectivity, every aspect. Let's get right into it. So one of the most important factors when it comes to headphones is audio quality. Which headphones sound the best? This is obviously a preference-based thing because honestly, some people may think something sounds better than something else just because it's the sound that they prefer. So when it comes to audio quality and just the way that it sounds, this is kind of a subjective preference more than anything, but here are my thoughts. No question about it, to me, what headphones sound the absolute best out of the box are the AirPods Max. I think they sound the most natural. I don't think that they hype the bass. I don't think that they hype any of the mid-range. Everything just sounds super clean and natural to me. That's really, really important for someone like me because I do like accuracy when it comes to headphones. And I really like headphones that make things sound as natural as possible. Right when you put them on without any adjustments needed whatsoever, when you listen to music, it kind of sounds to me like what it really should sound like. And as someone who really appreciates good audio, I really like that about headphones because not only does it sound natural to me when I'm listening to music, but they become more usable to me when I'm doing something like editing because they can be a little bit more of reference to how I really want to mix something if I'm making music or if I'm actually mixing audio to video, whatever it is. No doubt, these sound the best out of the box, in my opinion. When it comes to the Sonys, I don't love the way they sound out of the box, but a huge advantage they have is that I can actually go into the app and tweak the EQ to sound exactly like what I want them to sound like. Now, there's one problem with that. That is great for when you're just listening to music and you're listening on your phone, you can go into the app and adjust the preference. The problem is, if I want to connect these headphones to my computer instead via a hardwired device and they're not going through the app, I don't get that same EQ sound. Therefore, I may get them sounding exactly like I want them here when I'm listening to my music or when I'm watching videos on my phone, but if I decide to use these as a hardwired device directly into my computer and I want to use them for something like Final Cut or something where I'm doing some editing, they don't sound the same and I can't tweak that sound. This is a huge perk to me because not everyone likes listening to music the same way, and even certain styles of music might have a little bit more of a preference that you want in terms of bass or mid-range, whatever it is. Being able to tweak this is awesome. Now, when it comes to the Bose 700s, personally, I think these don't sound good at all. Once again, audio is a preference-based thing, so doesn't mean that you wouldn't like the way they sound, but when I compare these to the Sonys and the AirPods Max, I think these don't sound good at all. They sound typical to me like I think a lot of Bose things sound, which is just a little bit too much low-end and not very clear mid-range. It just, I don't like the way they sound very much at all. Now, back in May of 2020, Bose released EQ adjustability in their Bose Music app, which is awesome because it allows you to tweak the sounds. Unfortunately, they had tons of issues with the firmware update, so they pulled the firmware update and since then have never released another update for it. Therefore, you are stuck with what, in my opinion, is a $350 pair of headphones that sounds like crap and you can't tweak the way it sounds. So, in my opinion, these don't even come close to the audio quality of the AirPods or the Sonys, and that's honestly the most important thing about headphones to me. Though they do have some nice perks, audio and the sound quality is not one of them. So the winner to me, in terms of just audio quality, how good do they sound? From my preference of music and listening, the AirPods Max are the clear winner. So I hope you're enjoying this video so far, and if you are, I just wanted to quickly tell you about my sponsor for today's video, which is myself. I have a monthly coaching membership where filmmakers and people that like tech and cameras and all that stuff and building business hop on a monthly coaching call with me each and every month to just talk about stuff. We're also part of a private Facebook group that is only for members, and the whole membership is only $150 for the entire year to hop on a call 90 minutes every single month to just get better and improve as a filmmaker or even just someone that's running a business. So if that sounds like something that might be interesting to you, I would love for you to sign up. There's a link down below. You can join the membership. You can pay monthly or you can pay for the year. I think it's super valuable. People tell me it's super valuable. I hope it would be valuable for you as well, but that's all I want to tell you about. Back to the video. When it comes to noise cancellation, that is a very big factor for a lot of people when it comes to over-the-ear headphones. A lot of people get these types of headphones to be able to use on planes or to be able to use for extended listening when they want comfort on their head, but also to be able to dial out all the sound that's around them. These all do a very good job of noise cancellation, but they all do it very differently as well. In my opinion, the Sony MX4s actually have the best noise cancellation of all of them. I think that it does the best job of kind of dialing out all the sounds around you instead of just consistent sounds, but it also somewhat pumps a sound into the headphones to help dial it out. So if you are in a room that has a heater or an air conditioning or something going, as soon as you turn on the cancellation, you will notice that the cancellation cancels out the outside sounds, but it also almost pumps an artificial type of sound into your ear, which you don't really hear because it's essentially just consistent, but it's doing it like that, which is a little different than what the other ones sound like, which is simply just dialing the sound out entirely. Now, one thing I really like about Sony's noise canceling is it allows you to dial in between 1 and 20, what they call 20 different ambient sound settings, to dial in how much of the outside noise that you want to bring back in. So if you're walking around a big city and you don't want to cancel everything out entirely because you want to make sure you can hear some cars, you want to make sure that you can hear just your surroundings, but you don't want to go into full transparency mode where you hear everything really loud, you can really dial in how much you want by simply just sliding this dial from 1 all the way to 20. They also let you take it a step further and hit this focus on voice button, which will actually bring in ambient sound from the outside, but specifically voices will cut through more than anything else, which allows you to have some conversations with people while not necessarily bringing in all the traffic from outside. It's actually pretty impressive how they do it, to be honest, and it works really, really well. Noise cancellation is great from these things. The AirPods Max also have great noise cancellation, and it absolutely feels different than the Sony's. Like I said, as soon as you dial it in, it will instantly cut off all the outside noise really, really well. There are certain things I've noticed, even like TV and things that are happening around you, that these don't cut out as much as the Sony's do. I think just what they're trying to dial in and how they do their whole cancellation must be a little bit different, because I feel like you still do hear a few more things in these than that you don't hear in the Sony's. But it could just be dialing in a few settings on the noise cancellation thing. Maybe it will change. I don't know. But because you can't change any of those settings on the AirPods Max, what you hear is what you get, and that's kind of it. The Sony's are nice because they can really let you dial in how much you want and what specific stuff you want while still giving you full cancellation when you don't. The Bose 700s also do a very good job of noise cancellation. They've obviously been doing it for a while, and they are really well known for noise canceling headphones. The QC35s and those whole series of headphones have always been very popular to people that like to travel. I personally still, because of the sound, wouldn't choose these, but in terms of cancellation, they do a great job. Still, in my opinion, the Sony MX4s have the best noise cancellation of any of them, because when you dial in just how good it eliminates sound, plus being able to bring as much as you want in, is a really nice feature. Now, the opposite of noise cancellation is transparency mode. How good can you hear outside conversations quickly when you want to and not have full cancellation? This is where they all do this extremely differently. They all have some nice little features. The Sony's have one of the most unique ways of allowing you to quickly let that outside noise in by simply covering the right ear. So if you are wearing these headphones and you're listening and just everyday listening, as soon as a conversation were to happen, by simply covering the right ear, it instantly goes into transparency mode, turns on the microphones, and let you have conversation outside of the headphones, which is nice. You can quickly do that. Now, granted, if you wanted to keep having the conversation, you'd be holding your hand over your ear the whole time, which might look weird to the outside person. But if you wanted to just turn it off entirely, you also can do that. But it is quick and easy to do this if you suddenly are on a plane or on a train and you hear something, an announcement from maybe the pilot or the flight attendants, whatever, you could quickly just cover it, listen to what they're saying, and then go right back into the noise canceling, which is nice and quick and easy. They also have a speak to chat mode, which allows it to simply listen in real time. And anytime that it notices you are actually talking, it will turn off cancellation mode and just go right into transparency mode. You could have your full conversation. And when you stop talking, eventually, which is the biggest downfall, it'll go back into cancellation mode. This is really convenient when you want to suddenly have a conversation with someone. The problem is it takes too long to get back into the cancellation mode. It would be really nice if as soon as it recognized I stopped talking, it would go right back into it. But instead, once you stop talking, it takes 15 to 30 seconds before it goes back into cancellation mode, which is a little bit annoying if you want to quickly get back into the mode. I personally would rather just cover the headphone quickly and go right into that mode and then have it go right back into cancellation mode. So that's what I choose, and I turn off the speak to chat. I will say that the transparency mode on the Sonys is not the best. It's nowhere close to as good as the AirPods Max are. It works. It lets you hear the outside noise, but it doesn't sound super natural. It doesn't really feel like the microphones are really as clear and as easy to chat with as, say, the AirPods Max are. But at least having the option to get it quickly is a nice benefit rather than having to go into an app or tell the voice assistant to turn off noise cancellation. It's quick to just cover the ear and have the conversation. But it's nowhere near as smooth and as natural as transparency mode on the AirPods Max. With the press of a button, you instantly go from noise cancellation to transparency mode. But when you are in transparency mode on the AirPods Max, it is incredible just how good and natural the transparency mode is on these. When you're in transparency mode, you literally feel like you don't even have headphones on. The conversation sounds so natural. You hear everything so natural. It sounds clean. It sounds the way that it actually sounds. It doesn't sound like it's being muffled through headphones. Conversations are normal. You can still listen to music through the transparency mode. It is the most natural that I've ever heard on any headphones. It's so nice to use because you just press a button, you're in that mode, you press a button, you're back in. So there's no automatic mode, there's not quickly covering the headphone. It's simply just a press of the button, it's instant and it's quick and it's super accurate and natural, which is really important. They've done this really, really well. I don't know how they've done it so well. It's also really good on the AirPods Pro. They know how to get that transparency mode working. On the Bose, as I said, the noise cancellation is very good and it does have a transparency mode built in. It allows you to switch between it in two different ways. When you have the headphones on and you simply press this back left button on your ear, you can switch between three presets that you have. So by default, it is 0, 5, and 10, so the amount of cancellation that's happening. And if you simply press and hold down that button, it instantly goes from full cancellation mode or whatever setting you have on to a conversation mode. It is a nice fade between them, which is kind of nice. It's not an instant on or off. When you hold that down, you go into a conversation mode very naturally, and then when you let it go, it just slowly fades its way back into whatever cancellation mode that you previously had, which is nice. So you can dial that in according to what you want. When you press it, there's a slight delay, and then you hear the assistant tell you what it's at. So when you press a button, it will say 5 or 10 or 0, and when you hold that down, you just can instantly go to that conversation mode. It does take, it feels like, about 2 to 3 seconds to switch fade in there, so it's not nearly as quick. So if someone randomly came up to you and started talking, it's not as quick as the AirPods would be or not as quick as covering your ear with the Sonys. You'd have to wait a second, or you'd want to just pull it off your ear. One of the biggest gripes that I have of the Bose 700s is that they do not have proximity mode sensors in them. So unlike all the other headphones, when you are listening to music with the Bose and you take the headphones off, it does not pause your music. It is the only one that does not have proximity sensors built in. That to me is really, really annoying for a headphone that's $350 because that's very common these days. And anytime you take off your headphones, it obviously should just pause the music because that's just natural. And it's kind of annoying that you'd have to take these off and then pause your music and or take these off and disconnect them from your phone. So not only do they not turn off, but then when you take them off your head, if you were having a conversation, you'd obviously hear a lot of music just pumping out of the headphones, which I think is kind of crazy. You gotta have that proximity sensor. Now, when it comes to comfort and all-day listening, this is the first place that I feel like the Bose truly get what I think is the highest rating. I think the Bose feel the best on your ears. They are very, very soft. They have a really nice, comfortable band to them, and they have just what I feel like is a very nice amount of weight. When you have these on what feels like a long time, they are very comfortable to wear. And that is a big factor for someone that is flying or someone that uses them all the time. The comfort is important. I think all the headphones do a really good job of this, but I think the Bose are the softest. They don't feel like they're squeezing too hard. They don't feel like they're too heavy. They have really nice, comfortable cushions here. They feel great. They really feel nice to wear. They have this little sliding mechanism so that you simply just basically slide these up and down to get this little bar on the top to obviously adjust to your head. So you kind of can just slide them up and down for the exact comfort. Unfortunately, when you do put them in the case, they have to be all the way back down. So each time you put them on, you're kind of having to readjust if you want to put them back into the case, which is a little annoying, but that is the case. But closely behind them is the AirPods Max. Now, while I do think that the AirPods Max are the heaviest of the headphones, they're made of metal, they're very, very well built, but they are absolutely the heaviest, I don't feel like they're heavy when they're on your head. This mesh design here that keeps this top from kind of having too much pressure on the top of your head feels really, really nice. I've worn these for an extended period of time and never feel like they kind of are hurting the top of my head like I get with a lot of headphones. I think all these do a great job of that, but these are really comfortable for all-day use, which is great if you want to use them a lot, as I've been trying to do over the last couple of days. The cushions themselves are very, very comfortable. The only thing I've noticed for some reason, and maybe it's just with my skin, whatever it is, but the material that these are made out of tend to get really, really warm, and I feel like they make my ears and my head really red if I wear them for an extended period of time. Now, that could just be my skin. I don't really know exactly what the situation is, but I did notice that after wearing these for a whole day that they really made my ears feel really hot when I took them off. And it could be because these are the only ones that are kind of more a soft, like meshy type of material, where the other ones are more like just a cushion or rubbery type of feeling or whatever those are made out of. Very, very comfortable to wear. Very easy to adjust the size by just doing the little bar up and down here. And really comfortable. Kind of a nice snug fit. They do press tighter than what the other ones do. So naturally, I have found that after I wear them for an extended period of time, they kind of push a little harder than I'd prefer on my glasses. So it can actually hurt a little bit after many hours. But that's because I wear glasses. But if you do wear glasses, that could be a factor for you. The Sonys, I think, feel different than all of them. While I think that they do feel like kind of the cheapest of the headphones because they're definitely what feels like the most plastic on them and they feel the lightest, because they are super light and because they have nice foams on them, they are very comfortable to wear for an extended period of time because of just how light they are. You really don't feel them on your head, and the foams are comfortable enough that they just kind of are comfortable to wear for an extended period of time. But they're so light that they, you know, just really don't feel like you're wearing much. They absolutely, to me, are the lightest of them all. The AirPods are by far the heaviest, so they tend to feel a little bit more comfortable just simply because of that reason alone. They don't feel like you're wearing much, which is nice. I think the Bose are the most comfortable for all-day use, but I think that all of them are right neck and neck with each other because they all have their own comfort side of it in, and I'd wear any one of these for an extended period of time and be comfortable with them at all. So they've all done a really good job in that area. When it comes to Bluetooth connectivity and speed and how quick it is to connect to a device and get listening, this is where things, I think, start to really separate just how much better some do than the others. No question about it, the absolute fastest, best, quickest way to connect is with the AirPods Max. As soon as you put these on your ear, you hear that little chime and you can be listening to music in what feels like under a second. Right when these touch your ear, boom, you are ready and you are listening to music, which is awesome, especially when you're switching between devices. Because these are Apple devices, when you are using a Mac or an iPad or an iPhone or multiple iPhones, it can be connected with your iCloud. So as soon as you are listening on a device, if you pause somewhere and instantly hit play somewhere else, it's instant going between device and device and device and device. That is really nice if you're someone like me who switches all the time, because you really don't have any limit of the amount of devices that you can connect to that are all Mac devices. You go from one to the next seamlessly, so fast, so quick. The Bose headphones connect relatively quick, but they kind of go through this internal audio message chime system that kind of seems like a waste of time. You press this button, you hear the big chime. It just did the chime. It says battery 19 hours, connected to Scott's iPhone, and now we're ready to listen. So that's how long it actually takes to happen. In comparison to the AirPods Max, boom, chime, and we're done, and I'm ready. The Sonys feel like they're random. Sometimes you press this connect button, and as soon as it connects, it's already connected to my device, and it's ready to rock and roll, and you're listening quickly. Other times, it feels like it takes a lot longer, or when you're using multiple device support like I have set up currently on them, sometimes it'll connect to my iPad first and then my iPhone, so it might feel like it's a 5-6 second delay between when it's actually ready to connect to the device that I want to. Both the Sonys and the Bose have multiple device support, but only up to 2 devices. So if I currently have my iPhone and my iPad connected to the Sonys, and then I suddenly want to do some video editing and I don't want to have to switch to another pair of headphones, I have to disconnect the whole device from the one device and then reconnect it the standard Bluetooth way to the new device, do what I want, and then go back and repeat the process to reconnect it to the other device. I use an iPad, a Mac, and a phone all the time, and not having it be able to connect to all 3 at once simultaneously is a little bit of a bummer because I kind of have to decide which one I want to use and go through the process each and every time that I want to choose a third device. Very similar experience to the Bose, as you kind of just have the connectivity of a couple of devices. The AirPods basically give you unlimited devices in your iCloud support / ecosystem, which if you are big into the Apple ecosystem, that's a big deal. Once the headphones are comfortably on your head, they all control the way that you use your devices differently. With the AirPods Max, you basically have 2 buttons, and that's it. You have a little digital crown here that rotates, very similar to what's on the Apple Watch, so you can adjust your volume by just turning it. I do find that it's nice because you have a little bit more preciseness when you are controlling the volume on these compared to the rest, which kind of go in steps. These are very simple to just turn and get to be the exact volume you want really quickly when you just reach up. You press in the digital crown, you have all your different options of pausing music, double tapping it to go to the next song, you triple tap it, it goes back to the previous song. It'll also do things when you get a phone call coming in and it tells you who the phone call is. You can press it once to accept, you can double press it to silence when you have an on hold call coming in, you could like double press it to reject the call, triple press it to basically ignore the first call, and there's like a lot of different combinations you can do. You can't really remember them all, but basically one button kind of does it all. The other button simply goes from transparency mode to noise cancellation mode, and that's its primary purpose. One press and you're in those modes. No sort of touch dials on any of these for volume or anything else. With the Sonys, everything is controlled on the right ear cup, so even though there are no physical buttons present, they do different things. So as you swipe up, you increase your volume of your device. When you swipe down, you decrease the volume. When you swipe this way, you go back to a song. This way, you skip forward to a song. In the dead center, when you tap it, you have the control to answer basically telephone calls and do all the kind of stuff like you normally would. Just like the AirPods Max, there's lots of different combinations you can kind of remember that help you kind of navigate your stuff, but everything is done right on this right cup. When you hold your finger down, it will automatically go to your voice assistant depending on what you have set up for that. So that's the other way you can kind of jump to that quickly. Then you have the little custom buttons over here that allow you to change what specific thing that does. The custom button can kind of be customized a little bit depending on what you want that to do. Then you have the power button, and that's basically it. With the Bose, it's pretty similar. You also have that same type of touch control with the right ear cup here, so you can swipe up for your volumes, you can go back and forth between your music, you can hold down the buttons to basically switch between active cancellation and transparency mode, so it's very similar to the Sony that you basically have this little touch dial here, and that's what controls everything. You also get call control similar to the AirPods Max, where you kind of have to remember what it does, but you can like double tap and swipe and do different things to answer incoming calls and decline secondary calls and all that. I personally feel like if you're on the phone already and you get another call, you're probably going to forget what that combination is, so you're normally just going to grab your phone anyway, just my prediction, but you do have some customization there. So they all do touch controls differently. I personally like the AirPods Max setup the most just because I found it quickest to just go up and get the exact setting you want and dial in the volume you want rather than having to swipe for each individual step. You're kind of doing this a bunch of times if you want to increase the volume or decrease it. I kind of like how this is just very seamless and easy to do, but they all obviously have little pros and cons of both. Now, if you don't want to use Bluetooth, they all have wired connectivity, but they all do it differently. The Sony is the only one that's actually natural and makes a lot of sense. They basically have a normal 3.5 millimeter cable that comes with it, that's directly in the case that you plug into the end of the headphone, and then you plug into a computer or a device with a headphone port. Nothing really too complicated about it. The Bose is also just a cable from one end to the next, but they have their own kind of cable, and it's a very, very small connector to the headphone, which then goes to your normal size headphone, 3.5 millimeter jack elsewhere. That's great if you have the Bose cable with you, but if you end up forgetting the Bose cable and you want to just connect another aux cable, or you want to have multiple cables in different bags so that you can switch at any given time, well, you can't, because you have to have that unique one that's very small. So that's a little bit of an annoyance, because they could have obviously fit a larger size in there, but they make you kind of use that little one. The Apple connector is by far the dumbest, because it doesn't actually have any sort of normal 3.5 jack or headphone style jack. It just has a lightning connector. So you either have to get yourself the headphone lightning adapter that costs money, and then you connect an aux cable to that to your device, or you have to spend an additional $30 or $20 to get the lightning to 3.5 millimeter jack to connect two devices. And that's really annoying to me, because for $550, you'd think they'd at least include that lightning to headphone port, like the cable directly in the box. Like, you spend a lot of money, they could give you the $5 cable. They don't, but sometimes Apple does those kind of things. I think the winner for connectivity is definitely the Sony's, because it's just the way it should be. It's a normal 3.5 millimeter connector. Connect it, and you're good to go. Now, one thing I don't think about all the time when I'm talking about big over-ear headphones is the actual voice microphone quality from them. Obviously, you can take phone calls and still have your normal phone calls with these. People use them for those. I personally haven't really done a lot of phone calls with them, because I normally use my AirPod Pros for those, but they do have a microphone. So how does each microphone sound? So this is the audio that you hear coming straight from the AirPods Max. I'm using the voice recorder app to basically record and let you hear what it sounds like. So here is the audio quality directly from the Bose 700 headphones. How does it sound for overall voice quality? And this is the audio quality straight from the Sony XM4s. How does the audio quality sound for a phone call, for a FaceTime, whatever it is? This is, would just be your everyday conversation that you're having with someone on the phone. Or maybe you're using these to be your microphone for recording a video, but personally, I don't really think that would be a super common case for it. You obviously can have phone call conversations with these, so how does it sound? Obviously, this is a very controlled environment, so it would be different in an outside environment where you're walking around and there's lots of sound happening, but you're having a phone call conversation with someone, you're having a FaceTime conversation. This is the audio that you get straight from these headphones. Okay, so I've now listened to each individual voice recording, and I do think that the AirPods Max sound the most natural in terms of just how the voice is represented to the other side. And I think that second place is the XM4s, the Sony's, and I think that the Bose doesn't have as best quality. Now, obviously, I don't know which one does the best yet out and about, like which one blocks out all the other sound. From what I understand, the Sony does a really good job of actually like really focusing on the person talking and really eliminating a lot of the sound around it, which is a really nice thing if you are in a big city, you're walking around having a phone call conversation, but they all do a pretty decent job here. I don't think the mic quality is amazing on any of them, which I don't really think the mic quality is that great on any headphones, because, well, I don't really think that you have that many conversations on the phone with those. Just my opinion. When it comes to battery life, all of these are absolutely great. They all will last a full day of using, no question about it. Easy. I think Apple claims 20 hours. Bose might do even more than that. I think there's 20 some hours on the Sony's. I don't even know the exact details. All I know is every one of them will last an entire day listening easy. And that's really all I got to say about that. They're all tremendous. Now, one thing I use a lot with headphones that I think is super convenient is the voice assistant, because when you have something on your ears, it's really nice to be able to have someone at the just talk of your mouth be able to listen to what you need and answer questions for you and do things for you based on how an assistant normally does. So when it comes to the AirPods Max, as you'd expect, the only voice assistant you get is Siri, because Apple owns Siri, so they're going to put Siri in the device, and that's the one you use. So you can say things like, hey, Siri, and have her do certain things just like you'd expect from all Apple devices, but it's Siri only. And if you don't like Siri, which I think she could still use a lot of work, you're still limited to just her. You can't get anything else. The Bose is actually the only one that allows you to use Siri or Alexa or Google Assistant. That's really nice because regardless of which one you prefer, you can use anyone at any given time. And you can just say things like Alexa, what is the time? What's the weather? What's the song I'm listening to? What's the my flight plans? Whatever. Anything you'd use your devices for, regardless of which one of the three you use, you can use with the Bose. That's awesome for someone who basically wants to be able to choose what they want. The Sonys simply let you use either Alexa or the Google Assistant. Once again, I still really like that because I'd prefer to use the Alexa devices more than anything else. I feel like they are the best, and it's nice being able to have that in my ears because I'm used to only being able to have Siri with my AirPod Pros. So when I'm able to have a different assistant in my ears, I really, really like that, and that's a really nice perk to me. We'll give Bose the win on that one though because you can choose any of them. When it comes to portability, in terms of just how quick it is to put in a case, how small is the case, and how easy it is to just fold it up and get it out and take up the least amount of room possible, the Sonys win, no doubt about it, in this category. The Sonys definitely have the smallest of the cases, and it allows you to simply fold up the case and the headphones inside the case so that it takes up what feels like the smallest blueprint of all of them. Footprint, not blueprint. Inside it also has the cable, and it also comes with the cable for airlines. And it folds into a nice little small portable case that has even a little pocket on the outside here. So if you wanted to throw something else, like maybe an extra cable, or if you wanted to throw something, an adapter or whatever, you have an extra little case there. By far the smallest of the cases. The Bose case is also not bad, but the only thing I don't like about the Bose case, as I mentioned before, is that if you adjust this for a bigger style head, every single time you put it in the case, you have to put it back all the way down to the lowest before it'll fit back into the case. So if you're someone that has to adjust the headset, every single time that you take them out, you have to readjust them for your head because they don't fit in the case other than the smallest. So that's a little bit of an annoyance if you are someone that has to adjust. Now inside of there, they do have this nice little compartment here that has your cables to charge and your cable for the actual connectivity hardwired. So that's nice, nice and clean. The case itself is clean and it's at least a little bit harder and more secure for them. So that's nice. But as you can see, the Sony one definitely is a little bit smaller. Now the AirPods Max, I don't really have much to say about this case. I think it's absolutely the worst, dumbest, most ridiculous looking case I've ever seen in my life. You basically have to either carry it around like a purse or basically just carry it around with nothing. So it's by far the widest and most bulky of them, even though it's just the headphones, because they can't fold down any other way. You can't fold it that way to make it fold up smaller. It's just basically this and only this, and you got to kind of throw it into a backpack, and who knows if this mesh will ever rip. It's just, it's a disaster. This is probably the weirdest design I've ever seen. And because it's Apple, they don't have any power off button. Therefore, they never actually power off. And only when they go in this case do they go into the really low power mode. So you kind of are forced to use this, or else they just will kind of eventually die in power mode. Apple, what is this? So what pair of headphones do I think are the best bang for the buck in terms of overall everything? For most people, I would say the Sony MX4s are the best bang for the buck. They are currently the cheapest available. I think they have the best noise cancellation. They have adjustable EQ for the sound you want. They have a really good transparency mode that allows you to quickly switch between it. They have great battery life. They're lighter. They take up less room. They have multiple device support. They have a great voice assistant, and they're comfortable to wear all day. And when you add all those factors in, and then you also make it the most affordable of the three, I feel like it's a no-brainer that these are the best bang for the buck. Most people would absolutely love these headphones. And these are the ones I'd recommend in that price category. Are they my favorite? It's really hard to beat everything that the AirPods Max has to offer when you factor in just how quick they connect, how comfortable they are, how great they sound, how amazing the transparency mode is, how just Apple they are. They really are a joy to use, and man, they sound good. But are they worth almost $300 more than the Sony's? Maybe. As for the Bose, can't say I recommend these. The only people I feel like really love these are usually people that have never tried anything else. So if you have always had Bose products, I'd recommend that you try something else, because most audio people will tell you that Bose does not have the best sound, and to me, the sound is most important. Thanks for watching.